Bipolar disorder is a mood disorder that's characterized by different episodes. So manic episodes, which involve elated or an irritable mood where people have exaggerated reactions in terms of their lifestyle with respect to making risky decisions, losing their need for sleep, talking fast, and making decisions that are really uncharacteristic of them and sometimes unsafe. In contrast to that, they also have depressive episodes during which they have a decrease in their motivation, lower sad mood, and changes also in their appetite and sleep, usually towards loss of sleep or difficulty sleeping, and also negative thoughts about themselves, even suicidal thoughts. Some of the challenges that come up in youth relate to the fact that oftentimes when bipolar disorder starts in teenagers, it's a more complex and difficult or severe form of the illness, which means that those adolescents spend less of their time totally well from mood symptoms. So even outside of episodes where they're fully manic or fully depressed, they suffer from what we call sub-threshold symptoms that still get in the way of teasing apart what's the healthy adolescent and what's their symptoms. So that makes it challenging. The other challenging aspect is that teenagers have a higher likelihood compared to adults of having what we call mixed manic episodes, where there's an overlap almost simultaneously of depressed and manic symptoms. So when we look at a severe illness like bipolar disorder, what we want to try to do is identify it as early as possible. And by doing that, we want to try to identify risk factors. And by far the most replicated or consistent risk factor is having a biological parent with bipolar disorder. And among children who have a parent with bipolar disorder, their rates of themselves having the illness are increased 5 to 10-fold. So we know that's far and away the biggest risk. The problem is, even if you have a parent with bipolar disorder, most children and adolescents won't develop the illness themselves. So the question that we wanted to address is, which of these kids are the ones that do get the illness? Because they're the ones that we're particularly interested in terms of identifying how can we prevent this in other adolescents by seeing the first signs or the first factors that are connected with later getting bipolar disorder. So what we already knew was that the majority of children or adolescents who have a parent with bipolar disorder don't go on to get the illness themselves. And it's only about 10% of them, of these children or adolescents, that get bipolar disorder as well. What we wanted to try to do was hone down or identify what the risk factors were for these children or adolescents having the illness. And one of the things that we found was that having earlier forms of more common psychiatric illnesses, so for example, anxiety disorders and what we call disruptive behavior disorders, so kids that have oppositional tendencies or aggressive behavior. Kids that demonstrated those problems were the ones that were more likely to have bipolar disorder. So what this tells us is that when we're faced with a child or an adolescent who has a relatively common form of psychological problems, those being anxiety or disruptive behavior, if they have a parent with bipolar disorder, that may be a different story than it would be if they didn't. So another one of the findings that the study indicated was that children that had exposure to antidepressant medicine or medicine that targets ADHD or attention deficit symptoms were also more likely to have bipolar disorder. Unfortunately, we weren't able to tease apart which came first, but it does lead us to the question of what the risk versus benefit is of those specific medications if somebody has a parent with bipolar disorder. I think what this study brings us to is the suggestion that if a parent has bipolar disorder and is being treated and diagnosed with that illness, and they have any problems in terms of their child's behavior or mood, that it's important that they let the treating physician of their child know that they have bipolar disorder, because it could inform the treatment decisions and the assessment. What we're concerned about is that potentially common problems in the general population, when they occur among children of parents with bipolar disorder, might potentially be the first forms of what will eventually be bipolar disorder.